We'll talk about a tree which is commonly called as gunpowder tree or charcoal tree, pigeon wood tree. This particular tree belongs to the genus Trema under the family Cannabinaceae, to which our hemp bhang belongs. There was a time when Trema was included along with khadak saltus tree in the family Celtidaceae, and sometimes also along with Almus it was included under the family Almaceae. But the genetic evidence has suggested the Trema tree, like Celtus, should be shifted to hemp family, that is Cannabaceae. So under the family Cannabaceae and the tree Celtus or Trema, we have the unisexual flowers, apetal flowers mostly, or perianth is present in case of Celtus but not in case of Trema. Fruits are fleshy, they are little fleshy as in Celtus and Trema, but they are dry in case of Almus and Halopetalia, but they belong to the same family under the Cannabinaceae. Trema word has come from the hole because its seeds have some kind of pits, depressions. Trema is unique tree. It is found in shivaliks, subtropical, tropical belt, not only in Asia but also in Africa, and it is called as African elm sometimes. It is also found in America, South America, Mexico, Florida. It is also seen in Southeast Asia and Australia. So it has about 15 species. All are unique. They are nitrogen fixing trees. Leaves are alternate. Mostly they are scabrid. In case of Celtus species, khadak, the leaves are smooth. But in case of Trema, they are scabrid, rough, hairy. Like Celtus, Trema is also known as the nettle tree. Nettle herb, which is called a soy or shed or sadar, is basically herbaceous perennial urtica. But this is a tree, Trema, which is known as the gunpowder tree or charcoal tree because its wood is implied for charcoal making and even for the gunpowder manufacture. It is called as pigeon wood tree because mostly pigeons and doves, they love to make nesting inside the entangled branches of the Trema species. The species which we find in Jammu is known as Trema palitoria. The species which is most prevalent in India, central India or UP, that is Trema orientalis. How to distinguish the two species? Trema, both are called as the charcoal tree or gunpowder tree or pigeon wood tree. In case of orientalis, leaves are scabrid only on the upper surface, and the beneath they are silky hairy. They are whitish beneath and they are silky haired. But in case of palitoria, both surfaces of the leaves, they are rough, scabrid, like sandpaper. And for this unique character of scabrid leaves on both sides, in case of Trema palitoria, which we find in Jammu Shivaliks, it is in local language Dogri known as Dand Kuchan, because it has the ability to scratch the teeth. So its scabrid leaves are also employed for brushing the teeth, They are also used to clean the utensils because of their scabbard sandy texture. Another feature to distinguish two species, Polytoria in Jammu and Orientalis elsewhere, leaves are usually equal at the base. Base of the lamina is equal on both sides of the petiole, but it is sharply unequal in case of Orientalis. This is another feature. Then flowers, they are unisexual. They are born on the same tree, monoecious condition, but the leaves are born in compact clusters. And in case of trim of Polytoria, which we find in Jammu, so flowering cymes are compact, densely packed, and length is shorter than the petiole, leaf stalk, not longer. But in case of Orientalis, the flowering cymose clusters, they are lax, they are not dense, they are not compact, and usually they exceed the length of petioles, leaf stalks. Leaf petiole or leaf stalk is about 6 to 12 mm, means approaching or even exceeding the 1 cm length in case of Orientalis. But in case of Polytoria, the length is smaller. This is about 6 to 8 mm. The particular Trima Orientalis has been labeled as very important tree from the ecological point of view. It has the larger ecological impact. At least 14 species of butterflies, they use this plant as the larval host plant. Many birds also feed on its fruits. Many insects also use the twigs. Even the pigeons and doves, they use it for nesting. In Gadwal region, it is called koili. Tree is called koili because of the charcoal making quality. Charcoal is called koila in Hindi. So from koila, it is the tree which is called as koili. And also called as khakshi. This particular tree, Trema orientalis, previously known as Celtis orientalis because of its close resemblance to Celtis trees, but now shifted to Trema orientalis. In Hindi, it is also called as Jio or Jivanti or Jivan. It particular in Marathi language in Maharashtra, this particular tree is known as Khargul or Khargol. In Konkani, again Khargul. Malayalam language, it is called as Amathalli. And in Marathi, another name, Ghol or Kapshi, is also seen. And in Sanskrit, it is called as Pranak or Jivanti. In Telugu language, Trema Oriental is known as Bogu Chetu. This Trema Orientalis bark is also used as adulterant for the Ashoka bark. Ashoka is Saraka Ashoka. Though not that medicinal, but the bark of Trema Orientalis is also medicinal. It is used against many diseases like cough. Even it is reported to be anti-diabetic, useful even in case of dysentery. Many birds, especially the blue-throated barbet, has also been found feeding on its fruits in West Bengal. In Bengal, it is known as Jibon Gach. The tree is unique in having the lenticels on its bark. Sometimes it is also confused with the Mutingia calabura, Singapore cherry, but this is not because it's without any petals. So in case of Mutingia, we have the white petals. And leaves are simply silky here in case of Mutingia, but in Trima orientalis they are scabbarded on the upper surface. There is also the proper use of species, and especially the orientalis and even another species of Trima which is called as Micarantha. It is found in Jamaica as Jamaican nettle tree, Trima Micarantha. Trima orientalis is Indian nettle tree or charcoal tree, and likewise we have even another species after Lamarck called as the West Indian Trima or Lamarck's Trima tree, or pain in back tree, which is found in Florida, West Indies, Bermuda and Bahamas. Trima Lamarckiana, earlier known as Celtis Lamarckiana, is a larval host plant for a very unique butterfly which is called as Cramer's 88 butterfly. As the butterfly on its under surface of the wings has a marking which you can read like 88 or 89. So because of that numbered marking on the under surface of the wings of this particular butterfly, Cramer's 88 butterfly, geologically identifies as Diaetheria climina. This uses the larval host plant, these Trima species, especially Trima Lamarckiana and Trima Micarantha, and also Orientalis. In case of Orientalis, the common butterflies which use this plant as larval host plant are Painted Cortesan Butterfly, which is Euripus consimilis, and another butterfly is Slate Flash Rapala Mania. The both butterflies have been reported using its leaves as the larval host plant, Trima Orientalis. We also have a species in Philippines which is named as Trima Philippinensis. Another is Trima Tomentosa, which is found in Australia, and it is called as Poison Peach. This is having the monoecious unisexual flowers, both male and female found on the same. And this particular Trimas especially, they are also used as the food, particularly by a moth which is called as Hapialid moth or Endoclita malabaricus. It also uses the Trima orientalis as the larval host plant. And another insect, in Inetus splendens, which burrows in its bark, it is also linked with the Trima trees. These trees, especially which is found in Florida, West Indies, Bermuda and Bahamas, Trima Lamarckiana, its fruits are eaten by one of the endangered pigeon, Puerto Rico Rican plain pigeon, which is Columba inornata webmorii. It is also fond of eating the fruits of Trima Lamarckiana in America. Lesser Trima is another species which is reported and named as Trima cannabina. So we have Trima cubensis also in Cuba, the discolor. Then we have the Trima domingensis, Trima integrima, Trima philippensis, Trima strigilosa, and another species which is found in Australia is Trima tomentosa, which is called as the poison peach. This particular Trima, especially Micarantha, which is found in Jamaica, also known as Jamaican nettle tree. It is also found in Nicaragua, Honduras, Paraguay, Venezuela, Cuba. Its leaves are egg-shaped and fruit is bright red. In case of Trima orientalis or Trima polytoria, which we find in Jammu, we have the black fruits. But in Trima Micarantha, fruits are red. This was earlier named as Urtica alnifolia, or also it was having another synonym as a Trima riparia or Trima mollis, but present accepted name is Trima micrantha. This is a Philippinensis species found in Philippines, is used as fodder in Philippines. These Trima trees, especially Orientalis and even the Philippinensis, they are used in as a shade tree in the cocoa and coffee plantations for shade. As these trees, Trima trees, are nitrogen fixing, they are used for the improving the soil fertility. They have very extensive root system, so they are very useful to for the soil conservation projects along the river banks, and they can colonize in the poor soils. So that is another quality of Tremas. They are pioneer trees in the ecological succession. These particular trees are also reported to be medicinal. So if we say our Trima orientalis, it is used against cough, sore throat, asthma, yellow fever, toothache, also as antidote to poisoning, even for the hypertension. Its bark, especially its bark, is also reported as anti-inflammatory, anti-arthritic, analgesic, especially Trima micrantha and Trima guineensis species. In Africa, the young shoots of the Trima, they are also eaten as vegetable. Wood is also very useful for paper pulp making. It gives very good fiber, having good tensile strength. So this is also used in paper making. Even the bark is used for making the ropes and cordages. So these lesser known trees, Trimas, charcoal trees, or pigeon wood trees, or dand kuchan as we call in Dogri language, they need to be preserved, conserved, and even raised in the forest nurseries for the ultimate plantations in the poor soils, along the river banks, in sandy locations, especially the nitrogen deficient soils. They make very good fuel wood, so these plants can be raised under fuel wood plantations, and this will also help in attracting many birds, butterflies, insects. So thereby it will also provide support to the biodiversity conservation efforts, as these trees are also food for many birds. Especially one study undertaken for Trima micrantha, it was reported that 513 visits of 19 different kinds of birds, especially the warblers, Cape May warbler, Satophaga tigrina, black-throated blue warbler, that is Cerulescens, palm chat, Dulus dominicus, even highland tanager bird, that is Xenoligia montana, and even this blue-throated barbet, Xylopogon asiaticus, is reported to eat the berries of Trima trees. So this particular tree is very useful for our surroundings, for biodiversity, for soil conservation, soil health improvement, and as fuel wood.